Good morning, everyone. Hi, I'm Liz Krueger, Chair of the New York State Senate Finance Committee. It is Tuesday, May 9th. I'm joined by my ranker, Tom Amara, to my right. And there are quite a few of our members have joined us, and we have votes for others. So with that, I'm going to hand it over to Jalen to start reading the list.
Bill number 110, Krueger, an act to amend the state finance law in relation to requiring commercial garages containing electric vehicle charging stations to ensure public access to such charging stations commercially, reasonable rental or fee rates.
Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Thank you. Any seconds? Hello, good morning, everyone. I saw Michelle Hinchy's hand first, so he shall second. All those in favor? Aye. All those opposed?
Nay.
Those without rec. Okay. Next bill. Bill moves to the floor. Excuse me.
160, Boyleman Segal, an act to amend the judiciary law in relation to audiovisual coverage of judicial proceedings.
Any questions or discussion? Anyone like to move the bill? I see Jamal Bailey. I see Michelle Hinchy. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Any without rec?
Without rec.
Without rec. Okay. Those three. And also, Senator Thomas without rec?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. Next bill?
419, Thomas, an act to amend the tax law in relation to authorizing municipalities to adopt a sales tax exemption for clothing and footwear after March 1st.
Any discussion? Questions? All those in, motions? Move the bill. Thank you. Senator Ball over there moves the bill. Second the bill. Senator Hinchy seconds the bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor. Next.
543, Generis, an act to amend the tax law and the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to treatment of gains from qualified opportunity zones in calculating taxable income.
Any questions or discussion? Anyone like to move the bill? Senator Hoylman Siegel, Senator Bailey, all those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nay.
Four Republicans? Nay. Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
We have Bill 110, Comrie. An act to amend the executive law and the general municipal law in relation to requiring an X-gender marker to be included in certain documents utilized by state agencies.
Any discussion or questions? Anyone like to move this bill? Senator Salazar, Senator Siegel. Oh, now we're changing it again. Hoylman Siegel, sorry about that, Brad. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Nay.
I saw two Republicans without rec. And Griffo, where are you?
Without rec.
Were there any other without rec? Okay. The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 1193, Persaud, an act to amend the public health law in relation to ensuring ovarian cancer survivors have the right to access screenings for health conditions.
Any questions or discussion? Move the bill. Did I hear you, Jack, said move the bill? Jack Martins moves the bill. Senator Bailey seconds the bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? Bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 1480, Hinchy, an act to amend the executive law in relation to establishing November 26th of each year as a day of commemoration known as Sojourner Truth Day.
Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Move the bill.
Second. Oh. Jack Martins, Tom Romero, both move the
me.
Bill.
I'm happy
with Tom. Oh, I'm sorry, you said Tom. Oh, I thought I heard Jack say it. Okay, forget Jack Martins.
Yes.
Did I get you right?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay,
yeah.
All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 1752, Hinchy, an act to amend the agriculture and market laws in relation to expanding the definition of crops, livestock, and livestock products to include cannabis.
Okay. Has it become livestock or a vegetable? I'm sorry, I'm teasing. It's a crop. I'm teasing. I'm sorry. Any questions or discussion? All those in, oh, thank you. Move the bill. Senator Bailey, Senator Brad Hoyleman Siegel. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Without rec?
Without rec.
Without rec. Without rec. Okay. Without rec. The bill moves to the floor. Thank you.
Bill number 1861, Brooke, an act to establish a Black Youth Suicide Prevention Task Force and providing for the repeal of such provisions upon expiration thereof.
Okay. Any questions or discussion? Senator Thomas moves the bill. Senator Salazar seconds the bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
2099B, Harcum, an act to amend the public health law in relation to enacting Matthews Law.
Any questions or discussion? Anyone like to move this bill? Senator Amara, Senator Salazar. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 2193, Bailey, an act to amend the criminal procedure law in relation to requiring accurate interpretation of statements made by deponents with limited English proficiency and accusatory instruments and supporting depositions.
Any questions or discussion?
Madam Chair?
Yes.
I just want to say I support this bill in principle. I think it's important, but I have concerns about the fact that this is just another burden on our already overburdened judicial system, the DAs in particular. You know, we've seen 40% of DWI cases in New York City dismissed because of the discovery laws. You've got other issues in our areas. You know, DAs in my areas, they're essentially outnumbered and underfinanced compared to their public defender offices. That there are many multiples more. So I understand and appreciate that the reason behind this bill, but I'm a no because it's just another burden. Unless we can support this with some finances, but again, understand the reason.
Oh, and I appreciate the support, Senator Varela. I'm glad that you mentioned that. So maybe next year around this time, the DA's offices will be fully funded because of the money we put in this year's budget. And also, I'm not sure if one of your counties, if they have some of the counties represent part of the 19 counties that didn't apply for the discovery reform, discovery fund that was made available last year's budget. And look, I want prosecutors to be able to get as much money as they can, but also want to make sure that everybody across the system gets as much money as they can. Because you're right, in order to be the right size, everybody has to play their part. This is just a language access bill, and which is, I guess, we have a couple language access bills in the judiciary committee. And again, it's a passion of mine to make sure that people within our state who are not necessarily privileged to have proficiency in English are still able to access our courts in the same manner that anybody else would be able to, right? Especially if you're related to the accessibility of justice, we just want to make sure that you have a fair shot at justice regardless of what language is your native tongue. This comes out of dissent, actually. I know we had a conversation about dissents in some of the judiciary. It actually came out of a judge of grammar dissent, and where the majority of people against, but this was pulled out, so I brought up something for the board to be able to put this in the legislative form.
Any other discussion? So I just want to add, in support of the bill, when I was on a jury, before I was a senator, no one will let me on now. I don't know about the rest of you. They don't let you on. They say you make the laws, you can't be on the juries. But before I was a senator, I was on a jury. And the defendant kept saying through his translator, he didn't speak English and he didn't understand what the police had been asking him upon his arrest. And the police actually the DA brought to court a video of the man in the police station upon the arrest where there was a tape recording. And we asked the translator, or the judge asked the translator, what is the man saying? And he kept saying, I don't understand English. I don't understand what you're asking of me. That was the DA's evidence. We as the jury threw the case out because as far as we could tell, we just had a defendant who kept saying, I don't understand what you're asking me. I don't understand what you're telling me I have to do. And that seemed like so obvious that they wouldn't want to bring that to court as their evidence in their side of the case, but it really woke up, I think, any of us who were there in that courtroom that day to the reality that a court can find against someone for something as simple as not even understanding that the person has no idea what they're being told or asked. So I think it is crucial, particularly in court situations, that you make sure that there is correct translation for everyone involved in an arrest and the process going forward. So I think even though it may be a new problem for some areas, although we do have that phone number that translates for you, right, when you call it. Do DAs use that? I don't know. Other agencies do.
I think they might, but you know, we want to make sure that there's a level of accuracy, right? Because we have our phones, right? We see the commercials about the translation, but you know, sometimes within certain languages, within certain conversations or a certain language, there are certain dialects, right? And there's certain colloquialisms which may not translate properly. So I need a court like an interpreter to be able to properly, you know, put this on the record, because I dare venture and be part of them, though, for those who are in the judiciary committee, you're hearing the same thing. If any of us were in a different country faced with justice, specifically the accusatory instrument, charging us with crime, we would want to make sure that it was translated into a language that we were able to not only speak, but not on a peripheral basis, but that we were able to comprehend and understand that this was something that we either agree to or don't agree to.
Right. Thank you. Okay, so someone like to make a motion? Senator Hinchey would like to motion. Senator Hoylman Siegel would like to second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
Nay.
Nay, nay, nay.
Without
rec.
Mine.
Yes, okay. Any without rec? Jack Martins was without rec. The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 2285, Cleary, an act to direct the Empire State Development Corporation to conduct a study on the feasibility of a minority and women-owned business enterprise capacity mentorship program.
Any questions or discussion? Anyone like to move the bill? Senator Salazar, Senator Hinchey, all those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? Bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 2311, Myrie, an act to amend the penal law in relation to fines for corporations.
Any questions or discussion?
Madam Chair.
Yes.
I think my understanding is this would be just for corporations and their fines. It would not just apply. This is supposed to be a level up for inflation, but it's not being applied to fines for individuals, just for corporations.
Yes, correct.
So, all right. Well, again, I don't disagree with the, you know, kind of indexing it to inflation in a sense, but I also think that fines are burdensome regardless, and if you're going to do this for corporations, they should certainly be so for everyone. It should be a level playing field, so I'm going to be a no on this.
Okay. Anyone else? Do I have a motion?
I just want to
please.
Thank you to that point. It's almost as if we're creating two levels of justice and penalizing, if we understand corporations to be persons, right, in law, the idea that we're going to create different fines for different persons for the same crime, it seems odd to me. I'm going to go without rec. I'm not going to go no, and I'll talk to the sponsor about it, but if we're going to level up, so to speak, the idea of doing so in a way that that isn't consistent is troubling.
I'm just going to ask a question of the staff. What category of crime and fines does this apply to?
There's a range depending on specifically for those classes. So if it's for a felony, again, the numbers that are currently in the law is from 1965, right? So right now it's $10,000. So based off of the United States Bureau of Labor Statistics, at the present moment it's $80,000. Well, more now because, you know, inflation is readily increasing. And so for Class A misdemeanors, it's jumping from $5,000 to $40,000. For Class B misdemeanors, $2,000 to $15,000. And for fines for violations, it's $500 to $4,000. And like the numbers as it is today, it's more.
So, and are these the kinds of crimes that would likely apply to individuals as opposed to businesses?
Yes, and not necessarily. I mean, corporations are subject to crimes that individuals that represent corporations are not necessarily penalized for those crimes. There's a specific immunity that individuals who are part of boards and members of those corporations, where they are not subject to these specific crimes. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. Senator Kruger, if
yes,
I may. The bill increases fines based on classification of the crime, not individual crimes. So whether it's mm-hmm. B felony or B misdemeanor, an A misdemeanor, a felony, it increases the fines. It doesn't distinguish between the types of crimes. So whether that would be one, to your point, whether it's crime that would be commonly charged to a corporation as opposed to an individual, it doesn't make that distinction. It just increases the fines for the classification itself.
Exactly.
So that's why it's a little troubling, because we're not doing the same thing across the board.
I understand. Thank you. Any other questions, discussion? Okay. Anyone like to make a motion?
Move the bill.
Thank you, Senator Thomas. Senator Salazar. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Senator Martins?
Without rec.
Without rec? Okay. The other colleagues here. I'm sorry, Senator Martin. Are you without rec? I'm sorry, I misheard you. I thought no. Thank you. Okay. Next.
2675 Fernandez, an act to amend the executive law in relation to establishing August 31st of each year as a day of commemoration known as Overdose Awareness Day.
Any questions or discussion? Thank you. Kevin Thomas moves the bill. Oh, Senator Riffo would like to second the bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Any without rec? Bill moves.
Bill number 2919, Cleary, an act to amend the executive law and the state finance law in relation to allocating fines imposed on real estate appraisers to the anti-discrimination in housing fines.
Okay. Any questions or discussion? Anyone like to move the bill? Senator Salazar, Senator Kevin Thomas. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any noes? Any without rec? Without rec. Thank you. Republicans here without rec. Next bill. That bill moves to the floor.
3468 Rivera, an act to amend the social service law in relation to providing parity to durable medical equipment providers by requiring Medicaid, managed care, or organizations to reimburse such providers at no less than 100% of the medical assistance, durable medical equipment, and complex rehabilitation technology fee schedule for the same service or item.
Any question or discussion? Well, I'll just throw in my view. When you have to explain to a constituent that even though their child is growing at a fairly rapid rate, but they're wheelchair bound, but Medicaid won't reimburse for a new wheelchair, even though the child's outgrown it, and you wonder how could that be, and then they tell you, well, it won't pay enough for an adult-sized wheelchair. While if they had private insurance, they wouldn't have a problem. I've also had the case of children having prosthetic arms or legs who were told that it's too soon to be eligible for another prosthetic arm or leg. They should just stick with the children's one. They're cheaper. But a leg that doesn't fit you doesn't allow you to walk. So I think it's crucial, personally, that we make sure that even if you're in a managed care situation, they have to pay the same cost as any other insurance plan would. With that, anyone like to move this bill? Senator Martins moves the bill. Senator Hinchey seconds the bill. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 4235, Cleary, an act to amend the state finance law in relation to requiring state contractors submit a statement on human trafficking.
Any questions or discussion? Anyone like to move the bill? Senator Salazar, Senator Hinchy. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 4648, Kennedy, an act to amend the executive law in relation to establishing the Office of Native American Affairs.
Any questions or discussion? Senator Ruffo. Oh, no, you want to move the bill. Okay. Anyone want to second the bill? Senator O'Mara, second the bill. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Any without rec? The bill moves to the floor.
Bill number 5207, Scoofus, an act to amend the state finance law and the real property tax law in relation to authorizing certain municipalities in a pilot emergency repair program to add unpaid emergency repair charges and housing code violation penalties, costs, and fines to such municipalities. Annual tax levy in accordance with applicable law.
Any questions or discussion? Anyone want to move this bill? Thank you. Senator Hinchy, Senator Siegel, Hoylman Siegel. All those in favor? Aye. Any opposed? Without rec? Bill, without rec. Senator Martins. Bill moves to the floor. Final bill.
5286, Parker, an act to amend the executive law in relation to prohibiting charitable organizations registered in the state of New York from using any charitable donations for confidentiality agreements or closed settlement agreements.
Any questions or discussion? Okay, anyone like to move this bill? Senator Salazar Wood, Senator Hoylman Siegel Wood, second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? And without rec?
Without rec.
Okay, Senator Mara and Senator Martins without rec. Okay, that bill moves to the floor. And we have completed the agenda. We are planning to have weekly finance meetings now that the budget is done. So we'll see you again next week, probably Tuesday at 11 o'clock, to double check the schedule. And thank you for your attendance and participation. I don't have a gavel, but the meeting is over.